This week at the Internet Cafe, the Weird Web. Are you addicted to lip balm? There's a website to help you go clean. This man is obsessed with Mr. T, and he runs a website to prove it. GoForce is a group of cyber heroes who keep the world, or at least the web, safe from the forces of evil. And what do you think this lady is into? She's our guide to tattoo and body piercing sites on the web. Plus, in our Cyber Blast, 6 weird programs, including 4 zany games. A look at the Weird Web, this week at the Internet Cafe.
The Internet Cafe is made possible in part by PC Connection and Mac Connection, the catalog and online superstore with over 10,000 PC and Mac products, award-winning service, toll-free technical support, and overnight delivery. www.pcconnection.com.
Hi, and welcome to the Internet Cafe. I'm Stuart Chaffee here with Jane Wither, Andrew DeVries at CyberSmith in Palo Alto, talking about weird stuff on the web. And we could do a whole year's worth of shows about weird stuff on the web. But what weirdness are you going to get into today?
Well, definitely piercing and tattoos have come to the web.
Isn't that weird?
Well, it's pretty weird.
These days?
I think so.
You have a pierced ear.
Well,
come on.
This is
you got a tattoo somewhere?
This is piercing of other places. we won't go into it.
One of those shows.
But I'm sure you will go into it later. Well, I have the honor of interviewing the originator of the Lip Balm Anonymous. Group.
For people who are really have a problem with dry lips, huh?
Lip licking.
Can't stop using that chapstick.
It's an issue.
Well, I'm going to talk to some guy who's here in the cafe who carries around with him about a 25-pound bust or statue of Mr. T. He's obsessed with the character Mr. T. He's created a website for Mr. T. This is truly weird. You got to meet this guy.
That's not weird. I love Mr. T. And I pity the fool who doesn't love Mr. T.
All right, weird stuff on the web, maybe this week at the Internet Cafe.
So, Kevin, now tell me a little bit about Lip Balm Anonymous.
Lip Balm Anonymous is a worldwide website where we provide information about lip balm addiction, methods for recovery, and other information on the lip balm industry and issues.
So now, tell me, is there seriously people out there who are addicted to lip balm, or is this a bit of a joke?
I can tell you, I was addicted to lip balm. I was using several times a day, upwards of a dozen in some cases. It definitely was true for me, and for all the testimony that we've received, it's got to be a real issue because we've received an overwhelming response.
So now you're telling me that you went through 12 or more lipsticks or chapsticks, Carmexes a day?
I used it, applied it on myself a dozen times a day in some cases.
So it sounds like it could be. And now is this because it's an obsessive compulsive behavior, or what do you think's causing the addiction?
Well, doctors have proven that there are people that lick their lips on a more regular basis than other people, and those people I think are more addicted, more prone to a lip balm addiction because their lips dry out faster, and therefore those people are going to want to use lip balm more, and therefore the lip balm is sort of a never-ending cycle.
Keep doing it. Now, you were telling me as well that lip balm actually dries out your lips. It actually doesn't moisten.
That's right. It feels good at first, but after about a half hour or so, your lips are actually drier than they would have been if you hadn't used it, so in which case you have to apply more and more.
So it's counterproductive almost.
Generally, yes.
So what's this drug connection that you were talking about with lip balm?
Well, a lot of the lip balm companies will give you free samples and or coupons for free samples. And this is kind of like the corner drug dealer whose first hit is free. And the lip balm companies want you to try their product so you can get addicted and therefore use more.
And once you do that, then you're pretty much hooked. And now there must be, you know, chapstick buyers and then Carmex buyers. It's kind of like a...
Certainly everyone has their own favorite brand. It seems to me that, based on testimony, that Carmex tends to be the most addictive of the various lip balms. That seems to be the one that keeps coming up for our addicts.
Well, it's more convenient because it's in the little tube and the little
and it comes
metal
in a little
box.
a little container they call a pot, which has got some drug connotations.
So now you mentioned testimony. Are there more testimonials for people who believe that they have a lip balm addiction?
Yes, we've received testimonies from people around the world who tell us about their problems, experiences with lip balm addiction, and ways that they overcame their addiction.
So give me an example of a sort of typical testimony that you'd get.
Well, one woman wrote in and said that she was trying to get some Carmex out of the glove compartment of her car, and it was a hot day, and so the Carmex had gotten pretty gooey, and it spilled over her steering wheel, and she lost control of her car. Now, luckily, nothing bad happened, but this really brought the point home to her that
she had
a problem.
Oh, my gosh. So now, it sounds like if you've got testimonies and you're kind of Lip Balm Anonymous, sounds like Alcoholics Anonymous. What if people who are part of NA or Alcoholics Anonymous, how do they feel about this website?
Well, we haven't really received any specific responses from other recovery groups, although several other recovery web pages do link to us, which I believe is tacit approval of what we're doing. We've received some negative feedback from other people, including one person who worked for Blistex who didn't appreciate what we were doing.
I'm sure they didn't. So now, if I had, let's say hypothetically that I had a minor addiction to lip balm, where would I start?
Well, you can start on our 12-step in recovery page. It'll give you the 12 steps of recovery. Basically, you can follow those, rely on family and friends to help you through that time. You can even get a mentor who can guide you through your recovery.
So now what about intervention? What if I have a lip balm crisis?
Some people really need to be woken up, and interventions could be appropriate for people that are addicted to lip balm.
I think you and I need to talk a little bit more about this. Okay. Thanks very much, Kevin.
Thank you.
Luke, we're talking about weird websites, and you have one of the weirdest I've ever seen, and that says a lot looking at the web. You have a Mr. T website. Where in the world did you ever get the idea to create a website in honor of Mr. T in the 18?
Well, I started it 2.5 years ago when the web was a lot smaller, and I first got onto the web, and I saw, there's no Mr. T website. That's a niche. So I decided to fill it, and I set it up, and I've been running it ever since.
Now, what's the fascination with Mr. T? I mean, why did you think Mr. T as opposed to 10,000 other TV people?
It was pretty much to me that Mr. T epitomized the 80s. He's the American pop culture of the 1980s, and I find that absolutely fascinating. So I decided.
Well, the first thing that I discovered when I went into your site is Mr. T is a real person. I just assumed this was an actor and a fictional character. But I mean, this is a real guy, right?
Yeah.
Tell us the story briefly.
Well, as far as I know, I mean, he started out as a bouncer in Chicago, and he won some contest, the world's toughest bouncer, that Sylvester Stallone happened to be watching.
He's a legitimate tough guy out of Chicago.
Yeah, yeah. He's a badass.
Okay, so he gets into a Stallone movie, one of the Rocky movies.
Yeah, Rocky.
And then
3.
What happens?
From there, he just sort of took off. I'm not sure why, but. Yeah, he became star of the A-Team, and then, you know, he sort of was a really big star until the end of the 80s when he pretty much disappeared except for the odd cameo. And
Now is this series still on here?
I think it's played in reruns on the Bravo network, I think.
All right, now let's talk about the site. I mean, what are the kind of things you got? I mean, how deep can you go into Mr. T on your site?
Well, I've got a biography of him, a sort of like likes and dislikes list, an A-Team episode guide, and the Mr. T World Tour photo archive.
All right, now I saw that. Now, how did you do? You got pictures of Mr. T like everywhere around the country.
Well, it's not Mr. T. It's actually this cement bust of Mr. T, which
they're fakes.
Huh? Oh yeah, they're fakes. Yeah, well.
Mr. T in Vegas. I thought you were there with Mr. T in Vegas.
Hanging with the T.
This thing was, what, 20 pounds or something?
Yeah, 20 pounds.
You carried this around with you across the country?
In my van, yeah.
You are weird. I mean, this is obsessive. Where did you get this thing?
It came from space.
Did you get this thing?
They're actually cast by this crazy French guy in Western Massachusetts who makes like cement Elvises and
Cookie Monsters. Why did you get this?
Well, this is actually how I originally got into Mr. T. Is I saw this.
You bought this where?
At a store in Cambridge, and I just thought, it's solid cement. It's going to last for hundreds of years. That's so absurd, Mr. T. So I bought it. And
then you go posing this thing in front of the Grand Canyon
Mount
Rushmore and all this ridiculous stuff. Now, on your website, you've got Mr. T versus the world's biggest tree. I mean, this is like weirdness embedded in weirdness. What is the point?
Why not? I mean, you get really big guy and really big tree. Compare their stats.
Did you ever meet the real guy?
I've never met Mr. T, but when I drove cross country, I actually had a second one of these, and I went by Mr. T's house, and I left it at his house.
But you never got to see him?
No, there's lots of guard dogs in between the
really?
Gate and his house.
Where's he live?
Lake Forest, Illinois. It's a really rich suburb
of Chicago.
You're
still back in Chicago? Right?
Yeah, yeah.
Now let's go back again to, you talked about this sort of what he represented to you, Mr. T.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, what does he represent? I mean, he's just like a strange guy with a strange haircut as a lousy actor, right?
Sort of, for the most part.
There you go. But he's got his own website.
Yeah,
website?
Why not? I mean, you've got the Starsky and Hutch website. You know, the world needs a Mr. T website.
No, but really, is there something that, I mean, why was the series so popular? This guy just came out of nowhere.
I think that's part of why I'm fascinated, is because he really wasn't the world's greatest actor, and yet his image has been on everything from breakfast cereal to air fresheners to comic books. I mean, it's a media iconification. Yeah.
Do you ever find a story on what's the deal with this weird haircut?
As far as I know, it's a Mandinka cut, and he says that when the tribe that his ancestors were in from Africa wore their hair that way.
Really?
Yeah.
All right, so we'll go to your website and check it out. Thanks a lot, Luke.
No problem.
You are our resident expert here on tattoos tonight, and piercing and modifications, and you have some beautiful tattoos yourself. Kind of tell me what inspired you to go out and get a tattoo, and how the web sort of tied into that.
Well, about a year ago, I've been thinking about a tattoo for a long time. About a year ago, I finally decided to go out and do it. I was having a stressful time in life, and it was sort of symbolic of being independent and being able to do something very scary, very painful.
Right.
Although, as it turned out, it wasn't as painful as I thought, and
it was
more painful than I thought.
Oh.
One of the things I did was to look around on the web. I looked at the tattoo fact, which tells about how problems you might have with healing. I was looking to see if there was glow-in-the-dark ink, things like that. And I also looked at tattoos.com, which is an e-zine that has a lot of photos, good articles about tattooing, a lot of links to tattoo shops and tattoo artists so that you can look at their work.
Yeah, I've actually been on that site, and I'm amazed at the depth and the breadth of different tattoos. Everything from it seemed like very nice tattoos to just sort of outright macabre, you know, sort of fantasy images as well. So did you see something there that you liked and went with, or?
No, I don't want to get something that someone else has got, or something, you know, that I'll see on the wall in the shop and get it.
You don't want the anchor and the sailor tattoo.
Sailor.
No, right. Okay.
So
something original.
The thing to look at there is you see what's possible, what's available, and then you can kind of work from that with ideas. I'm not much of an artist.
Right.
And when you go to the tattoo shop, you describe to the artist what you want.
Right.
So, you know, you have to have some idea.
Right.
You know,
and it seems like anything is really possible. I mean, I was amazed. I saw a guy with his whole head covered in tattoos and full backs. And
That would be very, very painful to get your head done, because tattooing on the bone is really
worse.
Painful.
Right. Well, and also speaking of anything being possible, it seems like branching out from just tattooing to piercing and other kinds of modification are also something that's getting kind of big.
Right. Well, piercing was how I started. And the first unusual thing, you know, I had like the ears.
Mm-hmm.
I got this eyebrow piercing, and then I hung a little dangly bead off of it. And everybody comes up and says, oh, that's so cool. It looks like a teardrop, you know. I had my nipples pierced for a while. I took those out. But, I mean, I've seen people with just about everything pierced. My roommate has an extremely large piercing.
I won't ask where. Okay, thank you.
And there's a lot of piercing sites on the web, too. And, in fact, often a tattoo and piercing shop will be together.
Right.
Or a site with a piercing will have also tattoos.
Okay. Now, I've heard of a site that sort of gives maybe beginners or less experienced people a chance to kind of play the piercing game, if you will, something at Mildred.com.
Yeah, it's Piercing Mildred.
Piercing Mildred, right.
And it was originally a different site, and I guess it became popular enough that they became Mildred.com.
Okay.
It's not really, it's a game more than anything, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It's an entertainment. It's not really a place where you would find out much about what it would actually look like to have a piercing, because they're cartoon characters, but they do have a lot of good information about, like, aftercare. You have to put healing stuff on the tattoos.
So you actually choose your piercing, and
you pick a piercing, you pick a body part, you have to take care of it, exactly. So it's not as difficult as real life, but it's, you know,
it'll give you a little advance.
Well, that's
great. Now, what's next for you? I'm sure as someone who has tattoos, you're kind of a work of art in progress. So where do you see it going?
Well, I'm still hoping to get this finished off soon. I wanted to get some filled in here.
Right.
And then I probably will get another one. I thought about like a full back one, which would be a lot of work.
Yeah.
I'd like to get something with flames if I can, but I think that could be very difficult.
Yeah.
I'm probably not going to go for any of the more extreme things, well, what I consider extreme. Other people might say, oh, tattoos are extreme, such as, you know, branding or scarification.
Right.
You can find out about all that at the body modification site, but it's just not for me, and I'm not getting my nipples pierced again.
Okay, good. Well, thanks, Muffy.
I'm Tweety Fish, a.k.a. Matt Force, leader of the Net's first and only superhero team, Go Force.
Go Force?
Go Force.
What is this Go Force thing?
Well, Go Force was founded in early 1994 when myself, Brett Force, and Professor Go decided that the Internet really needed a good sense of superhero justice and the vigilante spirit.
So, now, help me here. Now, you're Matt, right?
I'm Matt Force, leader of the team.
Now, why are you the leader of the team?
I have the best hair.
Clearly. I had a feeling that might have been what you were going to say, but I wasn't sure, and I'm glad you took it out. Now, tell me about Brett. He's your brother, isn't he?
He's a little bit of a black sheep. We like him. We love him. He's our brother. But he was raised by dingoes in Australia. You can never tell what he's going to do, but in a pinch, he's good, with a capital G, good to the core.
What about the professor?
The professor's a whiz. He builds all our gadgets, he keeps up the mansion, he keeps up the TIM, our vehicle, the temporally intransigent morphing machine, and he... Gosh, he's smart.
He's a magnificent man. Is he really the spine behind the organization?
He's the spine, the brains, the nerves, the lungs. He's what keeps us going, along with Gail, our mother.
Gail, now, I know there's a bit of a sad story about Gail. Can you tell me a little bit about that?
Well, Gail Force, our sainted mother, was killed several years ago in a yachting accident. Luckily, divers were able to salvage her consciousness and implant it in an intelligent supercomputer, which now forms the hub of Go Force's computer network, dispensing tactical advice, mapping, weapons, grids, and also motherly advice when we seem to need it.
And those are important things to have when you're a superhero.
What would any superhero be without his mom?
Well, now, what would any superhero be without his arch-villain?
The elusive and mysterious Aztec Lou.
Tell me about Aztec Lou.
I knew this would come up. Aztec Lou, 30-foot tall, exoskeletal body, actually only 3 feet 4 inches tall. You wouldn't imagine what kind of chip that puts on a guy's shoulder.
Unbelievable.
He goes around the neck committing evil like you wouldn't believe, and it's our job to find him and to stop him.
Go, Matt, go. Now, Matt, is it true that you think that part of Aztec Lou's plan is something to do with Barney, the purple dinosaur?
You know, most people think Barney's a dinosaur. He's not. He's a robot, an intelligent robot, controlled by Aztec Lou and his evil forces in the cult of the dead cow, trying to destroy us all with his insipid songs about happiness and joy and friendship and children.
So you're telling me it's all a lie?
It's all a lie. It's all an evil, evil lie.
Now, is it true about Bert?
I love Bert. I'll tell you now, I love Bert. He used to be good. He used to be good. He used to treat Ernie like a saint, but then he started hitting the bottle.
Oh.
Tequila, Everclear, you name it. He's a Muppet, so he can take it. It just makes him a bad man. In with Hitler, in with Stalin, in with all the biggest evils, even Aztec Lou.
It pains me to hear this story, Matt, but I know that with you and your team from Go Force that you can make the difference.
We hope so. We pray so. With the Net support, we will.
Thanks, Matt.
Thank you.
On this Cyber Blast, we're going to send you 6 weird programs that can be found on the web. We'll be downloading nearly 4 megabytes of code to you in less than 120 seconds. You can actually see the data downloading over here. To get these files this fast through the TV signal, you need a card for your computer called a TV modem. We'll tell you more about that later. You can also download these files off the web using your regular telephone modem. Download time at 28.8 will be about half an hour.
Now let me tell you what we're sending you. First of all, a wild game called Crazy Drake. This is a platform scroller, much like an earlier game called Earthworm Jim. It's one of the most popular game downloads on the web. Then a classic, the 1980s arcade hit Defender, ported for the PC. And a great little game called Passage Plus, a perfect way to relax during a PC break. We're also sending you Zone Rings from Outer Space. This is a virtual kaleidoscope on your PC that creates spirograph-type images using polygons and can turn your screen into an amazing palette of swirling images. And we're sending you World Counter, a little screensaver that shows you the current population of the world. And finally, we're sending you a tremendously valuable and practical tool, WinZip 95. This will let you decode various popular email compression formats such as UUcode, BinHex, and MIME. Remember, we're sending all six programs to you right now through the television signal using our CyberBlast technology. The speed of this download is equivalent to that of about a 400 kbps modem, so it's a lot faster than using your usual modem. If you need information on how to receive a CyberBlast or on how to install a TV modem, just check out the Internet Cafe section of our website at www.pctv.com. You'll also find information there on how to download these files directly from the net using your standard telephone modem. So it looks like the download is just about complete. Have fun with your new software. That wraps up this CyberBlast on the Internet Cafe. I'm Giles Bateman.
So Jane, we've gone from very weird
to weirder.
Right, exactly, and I think it's only going to get worse here. I've been up looking for some weird sites, and for me a milestone of a weird site is when you're on the site for 15, 20 minutes and you really can't figure out what they do.
what the heck is this thing
right.
all about?
I found this performance artist in Australia. His name is Stellarc, and he does these performance pieces where he combines the net with his body, basically, putting probes into his actual muscles that allow people from remote to control his body to move through electronic stimulation and things like
really?
That.
Really?
Yes, very, very weird. And he even has probes in his stomach or
inside
his...
Inside his stomach.
Yes, he's doing something with in his stomach or in his lungs. I don't quite know how he got them there, but he's sending photographs up onto the web as well during these performances.
Is that kind of like inner art?
You know, I don't know, but it just scared me, so I went away from it. But it's a great site to check out and get kind of weirded out. Something else that really kind of cracked me up was a site called Bert is Evil.
You mean Bert from Sesame Street?
I mean Bert from Sesame Street.
My Bert of Bert and Ernie?
Exactly. In fact, there are some photos on that site that will shock you, like the fact that Bert may have actually taken Ernie into a strip club. And I heard that Ernie ran out crying.
Oh, what a mess. Is this the same site that makes mention of Bert being at the same place in Dallas when John F. Kennedy was shot?
Exactly. There could be some tie-in as well. So, and there's also something about Michael Jackson in Bert.
I don't want to know.
No, we won't go there. So that's definitely another weird site. If you haven't had enough weird, there's also Beyond Weird, which takes you to the next step. There's things on there. Would you like to buy insurance in case you're abducted by a UFO? Well,
it's always something to consider.
Exactly. Well, you can find that out there. I think I saw something on the exploding whale
there.
The
exploding whale is there.
And
yeah.
Have you seen anything else up there?
Well, I thought the one that was neat for me was the Do You Believe in Ghost sites?
Ah.
So there's lots of different stories about ghost stories and hauntings.
Right.
And
now, do you believe in ghosts?
Absolutely.
Well, I've got a ghost story for you.
Really?
Yeah. Now, let's
just get... Jane.
Stuart.
All in all, I mean, I don't think the stuff was that weird we talked about tonight, or am I just, I've just seen too much weird stuff on the web?
Weird?
Weird. W-E-I-R-D.
Okay. Exploding whales. Okay. No, there's more. A man who, as an artist, inserts things through his body so that you can view art in his stomach.
On
That's
the web.
Weird.
This is weirdness in life. I mean, it was just reflected in the web.
Just a
It's very weird stuff.
Altogether like strange stuff.
That's a weird
for me.
Part of life.
Right. Well, I agree. It was definitely weird stuff in life reflected. Yeah. And some of it, I think, shouldn't have been reflected because I didn't really want to look at it.
You're talking about the tattoo and the piercing stuff?
I like tattoos and some piercing, but there was some piercing with padlocks and some starting to get on sort of mutilation that I just didn't want to see.
So. And you can see these pictures on these
websites?
You can
find these pictures on these websites as well.
I didn't see it either. Well, I mean, I had wholesome weirdness, right? I mean, I had a guy who just was obsessed with Mr. T, and carries around this, you know, this statue. He just is in love with this whole idea of this weird character. So, I mean, that's not so bad.
No, it's great for Mr. T.
Yeah.
And where else can you go to meet a superhero on the internet?
And you did.
I did.
So exciting.
Go.
Wow. Okay, well, that was our attempt to look at weirdness on the web. We'll see you here next week at the Internet Cafe.
The Internet Cafe is made possible in part by PC Connection and Mac Connection, the catalog and online superstore with over 10,000 PC and Mac products, award-winning service, toll-free technical support, and overnight delivery. www.pcconnection.com.